Let us introduce a new homology today and then relate it to the singular homology. This is called CW homology, just like we had simplicial homology, and this is applicable only for CW complexes. Of course, because simplicial complexes are CW complexes, it will be applicable for simplicial complexes also, but not for arbitrary spaces. So before that, let me recall a result that we have put as an exercise earlier, exercise 3.5. Now I will state it as a theorem and indicate a proof also, which is one-line proof actually. On the category of topological triples, X, A, B, there is a functorial long exact sequence of singular homology modules. Hn of AB, Hn of XB, Hn of XA, and then the delta homomorphism back to Hn minus 1 of AB and so on. So I have not bothered to write down what are the maps. Slowly you will know by the context itself what are the homomorphisms there. Remember, what is the meaning of a topological triple? Just like topological pair consists of two spaces, A subsets of A, subspace of X. Now here you have to take B is a subspace of A, subspace of X. So X is topological space, and then you are taking two subsets, one inside the other. So smaller things are written later. So X, A, B. So X contains A, contains B. So that is a triple. So this forms a category with morphisms from form of continuous functions. So X going to Y, A going to say A prime, and B going to B prime correspondingly. So that is the meaning of a morphism inside the category of triples. So once you have that, you take the singular homology of XA, singular homology of XB, singular homology of AB. So these three things will fit together into a long homology exact sequence. So this is not any mystery or anything. It's a one-line proof from whenever you have a short exact sequence of chain complexes, we have assigned through snake lemma a long exact sequence of homologies. And that's what you have to do. Namely, look at S of B, S of A, and S of X. One sitting inside the other. Sx is the largest, contains Sa as a subcomplex, contains Sb as a subcomplex. Okay, therefore, Sa modulo Sb becomes a chain complex on its own, the quotient complex. Similarly, Sx modulo Sb is also a chain complex. Similarly, Sx mod Sa is also chain complex. But by the ordinary usual isomorphism theorem of abelian groups, Sa by Sb will be a subcomplex of Sx by Sb. So there is an inclusion map here. Inclusion induced homomorphism from Sa to Xb goes to Sa modulo Sb to Sx modulo Sb. Similarly, Sx is Sx here. Sb is a submodule of Sa, so quotienting out this one, then further quotient, this will be another quotient, so there is subject. And the whatever isomorphism theorem, Noether's isomorphism theorem, I don't know, first or second or whatever, that tells you that the kernel of this one is precisely Sa by Sb. Okay, so you have such a short exact sequence, Now, if you take the long exact sequence, what you get? Hi of this, which is nothing but hi of a comma b. Then this is hi of x comma b. And then this is hi of x comma a. And then hn minus 1 of this. So the theorem and the proof is over. So this is what we are going to use now quite heavily. So I don't want to leave it as unnoticed, unproved and so on. Okay. Okay, so this was the preparation there. Now, let us start with, as usual, instead of directly attacking the CW complex, let us start with the one stage, namely, X is obtained from Y by attaching only one kind of cells, namely N cells, a family of N cells. That family could be finite or infinite, we don't care. Would X be attached by, X be obtained by attaching N cells E and J to Y via the attaching maps alpha J, which are defined on the boundary of Dn to Y. Okay. Once you have this collection, let me put alpha, a homomorphism from direct sum of copies of Z. How many copies I take? As many as the indexing set here, J in J. Okay. Take direct sum of infinite cyclic groups, as many as the indexing set here, to Yn minus 1, Hn minus 1 of Y. This group. What are this? What is this homomorphism? The homomorphism can be defined provided you define it on each component here, right? Namely, on each generator of this component, whatever, which when restricted to the jth summand here is equal to the alpha j star. Alpha j is a map from Sn minus 1 to Y. So when you pass on to the homology, Hn minus 1 of Sn minus 1 is infinite cyclic. That copy I am identifying with the jth copy here, alpha j here. Okay, so z, this is hn minus 1 of sn minus 1 is z. Okay, that is identified with jth copy. Take that homomorphism on the jth copy. So once you have defined these things, alpha is completely defined. Okay, it's a sum total of all these maps. So we have defined what is this alpha. Now this alpha is going to play the role in the homology of X. Then the first statement A is the relative homology of this X comma Y is zero except at K equal to N. At K equal to N, it is just a direct sum of infinitely many copies of Z. How many copies? I mean, finite or infinite, I don't care. As many as the indexing set J. Okay, for K equal to N. That is the first part. The second part is the inclusion map from Y to X. Okay, when you pass to the homology, it's an isomorphism for all I not equal to n minus 1 and n. At n minus 1 and n, there is some disturbance because of the attaching cell. So that is the meaning of this one. The inclusion in this homomorphism is an isomorphism for all k not equal to n and n minus 1. So this must be k here, okay? The third condition, C, there is another statement, it is not yet over. C and D are there. I star from Hn minus 1 to Hn minus 1 of X. So this was not included here. When K equal to N minus 1 and K equal to N, those two, what happens? That's what C and D tell you. So I star from Hn minus 1 to Y to Hn minus 1. This is a onto map. It's a rejection. And its kernel is precisely equal to the image of alpha. Hn minus 1. You see, this will, kernel will be subgroup of this one. That's equal to the image of alpha. Alpha is this map. Okay. Similarly, statement D says that on nth homology, Hn of Y to Hn of X, it is injective. Okay, so Hn of Y will be a subgroup of Hn of X, and with Hn of X itself is isomorphic to this subgroup direct sum, the kernel of alpha. So this subgroup will come here, the subgroup of this direct sum, kernel of alpha is a subgroup of that. That will be a component of Hn of X as a direct sum. And what is the other component? It's image of I star, image of Hn. So this gives you a complete picture of the homology of X, okay, in terms of the homology of Y, and how you have attached the functions, how you have attached those things. Attaching maps have a role to play here, where in fact exactly at one single place, elsewhere it doesn't matter, namely wherever the homology of Sn minus 1 was non-trivial, namely Hn minus 1 of Sn. Okay, so look at the induced map. Those alpha j stars will have the, they have some say in the homology of X finally. Okay, so let us go through the proof of this one. Proof of A, for each j, choose a pj in the interior of this cell. Think of this as actually the zero of the disk. Okay, you can actually take the homeomorphism disk and take zero and take this image, for example. Okay, for each j, you take that point and put u equal to x minus all these points, x minus pj, j in j. Throw away all the center points of all the attached cells. Okay, then whatever is left out, namely u, u will strongly deform the track to y. Y is a deformation retract of u, actually strong deformation retract of u, because all these cells can be collapsed to the f of image of f alpha or whatever attaching map. Okay, f alpha or alpha, alpha j's. What did I say? What are the attaching maps I have written down? Alpha j's. So alpha j of the image, that will go. Okay, they will go inside that one. So y is a deformation retract of u. Therefore, from the long exact sequence of the homology of the triple, x, u, y. We studied x, a, b, right? Instead of a and b, you put u and y. What you get? Hi of ui to hi of xy. Then there is an inclusion map. I want you to pay attention to this one. That's why I have put eta 1 star here. Hi of xu to hi minus 1 of u, and so on. Okay. This map becomes, this the central becomes, it's an isomorphism. Why? Because both this and this are zero. Because u is a, y is a strong retract of u. They are the homotopy equivalent. By the homology exact sequence of u comma y itself, it will follow that this is zero for all I. This is all, both of them are zero. So this is an isomorphism. So eta 1 is the inclusion map from xy to xu, okay, induced an isomorphism in all the homologies. This is the first thing you have to do. Okay, so xy can be computed from computing xu, homology of xu. If first we wanted to compute a homology of xy, right, x modulo y. So it can be computed x modulo u. All right, now let us put v equal to the disjoint union of all the interiors of these cells. Then U is open in X. Okay, U is what? U was X minus all the points, all the PA center point. That is also open. V is open. So UV is an excessive coupler. U union V is the whole space X. Okay. Therefore, the inclusion map V intersection U to X U induces isomorphism in homology groups. This is the excision theorem here. Okay. Now look at the pair V, V intersection U. V is the disjoint union of all these open cells. And V intersection U is throwing away all the center points, one of the interior points. Okay. So this is a disjoint union of pairs like this, interior of EJ minus PJ. What are these? These are, the homology of this one is nothing but, by excision, homology of the closed disk D minus the closed disk D minus zero, I can say. PJ goes to zero under this homeomorphism. You can write any other point also, no problem. It must be an interior point. Okay, and that we know is the homology of the pair DNSN minus one. And this we have computed. This is zero except at n equal to k equal to n. And then it is infinite cyclic. Okay. So each of them is infinite cyclic, and this is a direct sum over J. So what I get is this group. Okay. Direct sum of the copies. Okay. So this is where I have put. For k equal to n, it is this one. Everywhere else is zero. So statement A is complete. Okay, so let us complete the other two statements. They are all easy now. B, C, and D are easy consequence of long homology sequence of pair XY. Okay, if we look at this, I have not written down here. Of the pair XY, HI of XY, we have determined. Okay, it is zero unless I equal to n minus 1 and I equal to n minus 1 and n. So HI of XY comes, HI of Y, HI of X comes, HI of XY comes, HI of Y to HI of X to HI of XY. The previous thing is HI of XY. So this will be an isomorphism. So that was the first statement here. Okay. HI here. HI, HK is an isomorphism. Only when a K equal to one, n minus 1 and n, one of the, either the top one or left one or right one will not be 0. One of them is 0. One of them is 0 will mean that either it is injective in one case, in the last case, and surjective in the first case. So this is B and C are, all these things are easy consequences of whatever we have proved inside here. And the description of what is alpha is. The long homology exact sequence of the pair you can apply. So what we have done is we have done a good beginning in this lemma of understanding the homology of CW complexes, one step at a time. We shall now launch a systematic study of homology of CW complex. Our theme is from parts to the whole. The main tools are just long homology sequence of, homology exact sequences and the excision theorem. Okay, just that is what we have used here. We'll keep using that. Okay, so let me just give you the definition. Maybe we will not proceed with this one today. Let X be a CW complex. Then each integer n greater than or equal to 0, we have the kth homology of the nth skeleton modulo n minus 1 skeleton vanishes for k not equal to n and is isomorphic to the free abelian group of rank equal to the number of n cells in X. Hk of xn is 0 for k bigger than n. The inclusion map xn to x induces isomorphism in homology for k less than n and surjection for k equal to n. All these things are easy consequences of what we have done in the earlier lemma, once at a time. So this xn minus 1 plays the role of y here. Okay, xn is the plays the role of x because xn is obtained by xn minus 1 by attaching n cells. Therefore, kth homology will be 0 for k not equal to n. Okay, so for k equal to n is isomorphic to the free abelian group of rank equal to the number of n cells in x. That is also part of this, whatever we have stated here. The extra thing will come there precisely, attaching maps alpha j, alpha from, so number of j cells are attached, right? So this y becomes xn minus 1 and alpha is the index, is the induced by the inclusion maps, this alpha j star here, okay? Attaching maps are alpha j's, right? So the xn plus 1 comma xn minus 1 is precisely this one. So this is a statement. It is 0 or it is this many copies of that. So that is a part A. You have to read it here. Okay. For part A here. The second one, hk of xn is 0 for k bigger than n. Now, let us look at this one. If k is bigger than n, okay, first you do it for here, n scale, right? So this is a restatement of that, that's all. Hk of xn is 0 for k bigger than n. Okay, if k is bigger than n, there is nothing there. There is no cell attached here. It's 0 all the time. Okay, this was 0, x, k not equal to n. So no matter how far you go, this xn will be 0. The third thing, the inclusion map eta from xn to x induces isomorphism k less than n and surjection for k equal to n. Let us forget about k equal to n. K less than n, what happens? Induce isomorphism for homology. K is hk of xn to xn plus 1. It's an injection. Xn plus 1 to xn plus 2 also is injection, right? So it's a composite of injections. So therefore, this whole map eta n from xn to x will be an injection. Okay. You have to argue there this way because why are you wasting it is as a composite of infinitely many of them. Suppose eta n happens to be not injective. That means some element in HK here, some cycle here becomes a boundary when you go to X. That boundary itself will be in some K skeleton, Xn plus R, let us say. But up to R, you can compose. So that way you get that eta N itself is injection, okay? Similarly, for k equal to n, surjection comes from the part B, part D of this one, part A, part C of this one. So let us stop here. Let us use this one next time to give a complete picture of the homology of CW complex. And then out of that, we are cooking up another chain complex for this X itself, which is CW complex. Okay, the homology of that will be isomorphic to the homology of X. So that is the beauty of this one. Okay, thank you.